I'd say the thing I love the most about my research is that it brings me into community with so many different people, both native and non-native, in the place that I work here in Wisconsin, but also in the places that I research and I sort of think about. So the work that I'm doing right now, as an example, is on a former Indian industrial boarding school in a town, a little town in Minnesota called Morris. And this school was created in 1887. By a group of Catholic nuns, the Sisters of Mercy. And it was one of 28 off-reservation industrial boarding schools that were created anywhere from 1879 to 1932. And these were schools of the most sort of strangest and peculiar kind. They were schools meant not to proliferate knowledge, but actually to sever it, to end it, right? A particular kind of knowledge. Native knowledge about culture, about language, about spirituality. And I've been always really interested in that process. How does one weaponize a school? This seems so different from my own experience in schooling. And so my work really focuses on the history of this institution because my ancestors were sent to this school. My great-grandfather, Joseph Villeneuve, was sent to Morris when it was a boarding school in 1900. And as it turned out, I wanted to know more about that. And so I went into the archives and I discovered that it turns out the Villeneuve family had many people that were sent to the school. We're counting at least 6 to 8 different Villeneuves. And it turns out there's these wonderful letters in the archives about how they got into all these arguments with the federal government because they were parents. Albert Villeneuve, a great-great-grandfather, was trying to get his kids out of the school. And so they picked this fight, which I have a paper trail of. And I'm very proud of those letters, the initiative that they took. They cared so much about their kids. They never gave up on them. And so as I've done work on this school, I found other descendants like me from Turtle Mountain and White Earth and Sisseton Wahpeton, so across tribal nations, across geographies from North Dakota to Minnesota to South Dakota, all the way to Wisconsin. And doing that work puts me in community with other people I wouldn't have known otherwise. People that are affected by the school, who are still attend the school. You know, Morris is now the University of Minnesota at Morris. And so I've been working with so many different students and faculty people and community members on the history of this school, that I feel like the best part of my job is meeting these people that I wouldn't know otherwise, that I get to explore and sort of reconstitute these connections that were so intentionally targeted by this place. Now we get to put them back together as one kind of community. We get to put these communities back together.